I didn't allow the tumor to kind of like, or even the surgery and all the side effects I've been experiencing to kind of stop what I want to do.
A car rally is a car race. What is a brainy car rally? I'm here at the Outram Community Hospital to find out more.
Brainy Car Rally is about getting the brain tumor community together and bringing awareness of the brain tumor and the cause of it to the public. Today's event is as a tribute and in memory of my late husband, Sean Low, who had passed last year March, including other patients that have left us.
Brain tumor is a growth of abnormal cells in the brain. There are many types of brain tumors. Some are cancerous, some are not.
In November 2016, I was diagnosed with endometrial cancer, and subsequently we actually found the brain tumor during one of the scans, which was actually an incidental find. My tumor is actually called meningioma. So luckily for me, it looked benign on the MRI scans. I actually had a very regular life, even with a tumor in my head. So yeah, that was how things were before I went for surgery. My cancer was actually diagnosed 6 days before the wedding, and we subsequently found a brain tumor. So, I mean, it was really the beginning of a new chapter, right? New life. Understandably, everyone was a little shocked. So was I as well. You know, there was not a lot of time to really process the information, but life goes on. So we still went ahead with a really cozy and intimate wedding, immediate family and close friends. So it was nice, and I think it really added meaning to the wedding day because it was literally in sickness and in health. And yeah, those were really not empty words that we say to each other, especially when my husband said it to me. Like, I think it really meant the world, and because I know he meant it as well. His answer was really immediate. There was not even a sliver of hesitation. He's like, let's go ahead with it. It's been about a year since the surgery. I'm still experiencing quite a number of, I would say, side effects. The main thing being the loss of my fine motor skills. Or we don't realize how much we use our non-dominant hand until we lose it. And I think that has been really challenging. I look quite positive to most people, I would think. But the truth is, I still grieve the loss of who I used to be. The support of family, I think, is really undeniable. I think I really had the biggest privilege to be, you know, daughter to my parents, sister to my two sisters, wife to my husband. And a lot of friends and family friends even, you know, people were really concerned. They shared their prayers and well wishes, you know, for the past few years, and I'm really very appreciative of it. So I think with that kind of support, you do feel lifted, and that really drives you to, or rather drives me to, kind of continue working on the therapy for the past 1 year. This is my reality. I have a choice over life. Do I choose to solve it, be positive about it, or do I just choose the alternative? And I know what my choices are. So therefore, yeah, I choose to work on it. Yes. I am really living up to the tagline of the event today, right? Really living it up to the fullest.
Yes. 我很高兴地看到她这样坚强.
She is a very, very positive girl, and she lived her life to the fullest. And she also encouraged all those patients which are like her. Keep strong, my first child.
We each have only one life. We can, like Andrea, choose to live it by inspiring others. I'm City Joe Carson, learning how to live life to the fullest at the Brainy Car Rally 2022 for Singapore One.